At the recent UN Climate Change Conference, South Korea committed to cutting emissions by 40% from the country's peak by the end of the decade. How are we doing so far, and what needs to be done to achieve this goal? Shin Ye-eun went out to find some answers.
탄소중립은 정부와 기업의 노력만으로는 어렵습니다. 국민 모두가 동참해야만 이룰 수 있는 목표입니다. 지구를 위해 더 일찍 행동하지 않았다는 후회를 남기지 않도록 합시다.
제주 Island was one of the first regions in South Korea that recognized the need to act fast. In 2012, it proposed to become a carbon-free island by the year 2030. I flew in from Seoul to take a look at how much it has been progressing so far.
One of Jeju's key strategies is encouraging all residents to drive electric vehicles. And those EVs are helping the island make the most of its wind and solar energy. Jeju uses energy storage systems, which store energy so that green electricity can be used at any time. And its Plus DR policy encourages drivers of EVs to charge their cars at times when a surplus is being produced.
We are going to use electricity from solar panels to charge the batteries that will directly go into EV charging stations. And we're using the Plus DR policy to give out discounts to drivers who charge their vehicles with the surplus green electricity.
Companies in Jeju have also switched to green policies, like mega coffee shop chain Starbucks. Starbucks in Jeju is eliminating the use of plastic cups. When you order a drink at some Starbucks shops in Jeju, instead of getting a plastic cup, you can get a multi-use cup like I have in my hand right now after paying a deposit of 1,000 Korean won, which is less than $1.
Customers can get their deposit back once they return the cup in the vending machines at designated stores. Goyang City could also be a blueprint for others. Its mayor was asked to attend the COP26 conference in Glasgow as the only city in Asia to share its green policies. The city installed mini solar panels on all 498 houses in one of its districts and created a clean road to reduce emissions from transport. The clean road uses leaked groundwater to cool down surroundings for people using public transport so they don't take their own vehicles, even in the hot summer. Some activists said to go carbon neutral, everyone needs to get on board.
You might wonder whether simply using zero-waste products can make a change, but it will. Because once small efforts pile up, they will bring a big change. So don't give up.
Instead of just thinking about how to tackle climate change, civilians need to take action.
After asking for days how South Korea can become carbon neutral, I was left with one answer. Everyone needs to be on board, starting with even the smallest measures in their daily lives. Shin Ye-eun, Arirang News, Jeju.